It was 100 years ago when the American Theater opened for business on 42nd Street in the heart of Manhattan. It was the first of many theaters on that famous street that became Broadway. Tonight, we celebrate the history of Broadway and our great heritage of musical theater, a century of excitement, laughter, and beautiful music. Broadway is melody, harmony, and most of all, rhythm. Broadway is a celebration of life. Its attraction is worldwide, and its style is widely American. Broadway is
something appealing, something appalling, something for everyone to come in to rest. Situations and complications, nothing pretentious or malign. Open up the curtain to me, to the high, to the high.
I love musical theater. Probably more than I should. My son, who's running the lights, will tell you. Please, Dad, have another one. Coming up, we're going to be listening to Blair sing Over the Rainbow. Notice the little tip jars that are on your tables? Show your appreciation for Claire de Clark singing Over the Rainbow.
When all
By the way, it won the Oscar for Best Song in 1939. Our musical journey begins with the early years of Broadway, where a group of talented composers and lyricists began writing and selling their songs from the famous New York district known as Tin Pan Alley, with the likes of George Gershwin, Cole Porter, Jerome Kern, George M. Cohen. These musical wizards dominated 42nd Street and gave the world some of its most treasured Broadway melodies. Were featured in the 1944 movie of the same name. By the way, North Point Christian Schools will be putting on the full production of Meet Me in St. Louis this March 17th, 18th, and 19th on Calvin College's campus at 7 p.m. at the Kazan Auditorium. Meet Me in St. Louis.
Thank you.
when the opening of a new Broadway show featured a cowboy ambling on the stage, singing about a beautiful morning. It was the beginning of a show that changed Broadway forever. A show where the plot and drama were developed, the music and dance, as well as the spoken word. It was different. It was new. It was Oklahoma. Penned by the up-and-coming songwriting team of Rodgers and Hammerstein.
Yeah.
are singing
Anything
You Can Do, from the 1946 production of Annie, Get Your Gun. In the musical, the song sets the scene for the climactic chart-shooting contest between Annie Oakley and Frank Butler. They will not be using rifles during the song.
Turn into quite a lady. Can't wait to teach you some shooting lessons.
You couldn't teach me a lesson in long-distance spirits. Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do anything better than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can be, I can be greater. Sooner or later, I'm greater than you. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I can shoot a partridge with a single cartridge.
I can get a sparrow with a bow and arrow.
I can live on bread and cheese.
Only on that?
Yes.
So can a rat.
Anything you can see, I can see fire.
I can see many no fire.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't. No, you can't.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can say, I can say softer.
I can say it softer.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
I can make my liquor faster than a flicker.
I can drink it quicker and even thicker.
I can make both big and you say.
Without being caught?
Sure.
That's what I thought you'd prep.
And no, you can say, I can say no, you can't. No, you can't. No, you can't. No, you can't.
What is it that we're living for?
be a lady to die. Love, be a lady to die. Love, if you've ever been a lady to begin with, love, be a lady to die.
So let's keep the party for life.
Let's keep the party for life.
Never get out of my sight.
Never get out of my sight.
Keep with me, baby, I'm a fellow you begin with. Love, be a lady.
Love, be a lady.
Love, be a lady. Love, be a lady.
Thank you.
it always stayed beneath my feet before. All at once am I several stories high, knowing I'm on the street where you live.
$6 billion, as well as the longest running show in Broadway history, and it continues to play in both London and New York. Ladies and gentlemen, Emma Schmidt on piano with Think of Me.
Thank you.
Early in the 1970s, two talented composers indelibly changed the face of Broadway forever. Even though they came from different parts of the world and wrote with totally different styles, each in his own way broke new ground in the history of musical theater. Where would Broadway be without the music of Stephen Sondheim and Andrew Lloyd Webber?
Just
Veronica sing I Know Him So Well, a duet from the concept album and subsequent 1984 musical, Chess. In the song, Svetlana and Florence express their bittersweet feelings for the Russian chess champion.
It took time to understand the man.
world with exciting new works and novel recreations of the classics.
Skin was still and the side was on. The shape of faces of gentlemen who never thereafter were heard of again. You trod the path that you have trod. Its dreams are. The demon cover of the streets. Kept the shop in London town.
Kept the shop in London town.
Fancy clients of good renown.
Fancy clients of good renown.
What if none of their souls were saved? They went to their maker in heavenly shade. Our sweetie dog. The demon barber of the streets. Rise, 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 rise,
Rhodes debuted on Broadway in 1987 and intertwines the plots of fairy tales from The Brothers Grimm and Charles Perrault. Jack the Beanstalk tonight will be played by Carter Strobel and sings Giants in the Sky.
Thank you.
100 years of musical theater. Feels like only yesterday. We actually started in 1889, and you heard us do Grease. The Fox Broadcasting Company actually put Grease on live on their network. Kind of a large impact that you can see that musical theater still has today if Fox is willing to run a live production of Grease. And those 100 years has led us to believe here at North Point that since you not only love the presentation this evening, but you express your gratitude by placing some folding money, as we like to say, in the tip jars, these young folks are taking, I said I wasn't gonna cry, I'm pretty passionate about sharing the gospel. This is why I wake up in the morning, and these kids are gonna do this. I never did this when I was their age, and I never traveled to Jamaica to do it. They've been doing that for 10 years. It's impressive. I think that is priceless, even more than folded money. So if you loved everything we did, don't forget, meet me in St. Louis. We'll be being performed on the 17th, 18th, and 19th of March at 7 p.m. at the Gazan Auditorium at Calvin College's campus.
Really have to.
Slater.
Kids I get to work with every day, and they have put in so much hard work. Can we just give them another round of applause? Jamaica. It really is life-changing for these kids. I don't know if I said it in this show, but this is our school's 10th trip to Jamaica. So we have had an awesome opportunity over the past 13 years to form some really great relationships with orphanages, churches. We can do devotionals in schools, the public schools, and it's just really cool to watch and see what God has allowed us to do over the past 13 years there. We're about 25 days out from going on that trip, so if you could keep the Dayspring Corral in your prayers, just for health and safety and ministry, that would be great. Thank you and have a great evening.